How do I recover my Outlook account? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you've been a longtime reader, you know that I get a lot of account lost requests or people trying to get back into accounts, specifically Hotmail or Outlook.com accounts. To be clear, I'm talking about Hotmail and Outlook.com, not Outlook the email program. This is Outlook.com, your online email account. All email accounts that use Outlook.com are, by definition, Microsoft accounts. That means that if you've got an at Hotmail account, an at Live account, an at Web TV account, an at Outlook.com account, an at MSN account, those are all Microsoft accounts, and you can then use the Outlook.com website to reset your password if for some reason you can't sign in. However, sometimes you can't. For example, the one that tends to bite people, fortunately it's not necessarily a disaster, but it can be an extreme inconvenience, is travel. You have a Microsoft account via Outlook.com. You have a telephone number associated with that account for recovery purposes. Good on you. You travel overseas. When you try to sign in to Outlook.com, Microsoft notices that you're not where you usually are. And sometimes that's the sign of a compromised account. So they ask you for additional information to verify that you really are you. They send you a message on your SMS phone. Unfortunately, you're traveling. You either don't have the phone or the phone isn't capable of receiving text messages wherever you are. As a result, you can't sign in. Unfortunately, unless you've got alternate authentication methods, which sometimes includes email accounts that you can access while you're traveling, there's really nothing you can do when this happens, other than waiting until you get back home. In an extreme case, you might have somebody you trust log into the account and do something, but in reality, there's really nothing you can do. The next most common is that one day you just can't log in. Either you've perhaps forgotten your password, you don't have it stored anywhere, or somebody's hacked your account and they've changed your password. Your password isn't your password anymore. If you've got recovery information set up for your account, then you can reset it. I'll point you at one of my articles, How Do I Change My Hotmail or Outlook.com Password If I Forgot It? And links for everything I'm about to mention will be down in the notes below this video. That article includes what you need to do to recover your email account if you've forgotten the password and you've got recovery information set up. There's also a Microsoft account recovery page that will walk you through a series of questions, things like passwords you remember, or email subjects or recipients that you remember. Basically, they ask you for more information to verify that you are in fact the rightful holder of the account. So there's a link for the Microsoft account recovery page down below as well. It's critical to realize though that if you can't prove you are the account owner, then you will not be given access because the standards have to be strict. Otherwise, hackers start using this technique to get access to accounts that they shouldn't. If you can't get access to your account through this technique, it may not be your account anymore. My article, How Do I Get Into My Hotmail/Outlook.com Account If I Don't Have the Recovery Phone or Email Anymore, goes into much more detail for this scenario. Now, other signs of a hack that sometimes cause people to be concerned. If people are receiving spam from you, that's not the sign of a hack. That's just from spoofing. If you take a look at the article, someone sending from my email address, how do I stop them? That will describe exactly what's going on. However, if they are specifically spamming your contacts, then they seem to have access to your account. This time, you want the article, "Someone sending email that looks like it's from me to my contacts. What can I do?" to understand exactly what you need to do. Another scenario, again, specifically with traveling, is that someone hacks into your account and they start impersonating you to your contacts. And they will often say, "Hey, I took this trip. I'm stuck in this country. I lost my passport. I need you to wire me some money." That's a scam. Your account presumably has been compromised. As soon as you possibly can, of course, you need to recover that account. "Someone stolen my email account and is scamming my contacts for money. What do I do?" discusses the scam and exactly what you need to do. So, changing your password is the first step whenever you are concerned about your account. If you can't sign into your account, you can't change your password. All of the articles I've mentioned, all of the scenarios I've mentioned, tell you what to do in that case. But once you've done that, the very first step, or as part of that process, is to set a new password for your account. "How do I change my Hotmail or Outlook.com password?" is a very simple how-to change your password for your Microsoft accounts. Choosing a good password is critical to maintaining account security. "What's a good password?" is an article that talks about exactly what that means. What many people don't realize is that after an account compromise and you've changed your password, you're back into your account, that's not enough. There's more you need to do to make sure your account isn't still able to be reached into by the hackers. Visit "Is changing my password enough?" for the list of things you need to examine when you find yourself in that situation. Now, many people react to problems with their account by saying, "I want to close it, just make it go away." Well, you can, but only if you can sign in. It's typically people who can't sign in who want to close the account. But if you can't sign into the account, you've been unable to prove you are the owner of the account. You have to prove you are the owner of the account in order to close it. But if you can prove you're the owner of the account, well, then you can set up your own new password and regain access. So it's usually a very futile desire that, honestly, there's really nothing you can do about. I do cover it in "How Do I Close My Hotmail or Outlook.com Account?" But the short answer is, I don't. Now, another common scenario is that people desperately want to contact someone at Microsoft for help with their Hotmail or Outlook.com account. I have to be clear, there is no phone support. There is not a phone number you can call. There is extremely limited email support. The article, "How Do I Contact Outlook.com Customer Service?" is the place to go. But like I said, you'll find that your options are extremely limited. This is what you might expect from free accounts. So, bottom line, most people do get frustrated with the lack of support, the lack of options and resources when they suffer an account compromise. Totally understandable, but it's also not until the worst actually happens that people realize how bad a situation they're really in. Are free email services worth it? Discusses some of the ramifications that might lead you to make a different choice for those important email accounts. Given my stance on free email accounts, what for pay email providers do you recommend might be an article worth reviewing. Again, for those important email accounts where you really do want more support and more options than as compared to a free account. And finally, all of this really relies on your having basic safety hygiene in place. That means good passwords, good habits, all those kinds of things. My most important article, "Internet Safety: 7 Steps to Keeping Your Computer Safe on the Internet," will cover those. So I hope this was helpful. I hope this will point you in some directions that may help you if you're currently having a problem. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic, and you'll know that there were a lot of links that I talked about in this video, you'll see those in the notes below this video and at askleo.com/4445. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.